Sickle cell anemia is a hereditary blood disorder that affects millions of people worldwide, especially those of African descent. Every year, more than 300,000 babies are born with sickle cell anemia. Many of them will not survive to the age of 5 due to anemia and infection. The disease was first clinically described in 1910 by an American physician named James Herrick as sickle-shaped red blood cells on the blood film. In 1949, Linus Pauling and his colleagues characterized sickle cell anemia at the molecular level, making it the first known molecular disease. Despite a complex array of disease symptoms and severity, sickle cell anemia has a relatively simple genetic background. In vertebrates, a protein in red blood cells called hemoglobin is responsible for transporting oxygen from the lung to all other organs. Around the time of birth, there is a switch from the fetal form of hemoglobin, made of 2 alpha and 2 gamma chains, to its adult form, composed of 2 alpha and 2 beta chains. Sickle cell anemia is caused by a single nucleotide substitution from adenine to thymine in the beta chain of adult hemoglobin. This point mutation leads to a single amino acid change from the negatively charged glutamic acid to the neutral hydrophobic valine. This change in surface electrical charge makes hemoglobin less soluble and prone to polymerization, especially at low oxygen tension upon delivery of oxygen to peripheral tissues. The formation of these long hemoglobin polymer fibers triggers a cascade of several other cellular abnormalities, such as ion channel dysregulation and membrane deformation. As a result, red blood cells deform. Instead of the typical smooth, elastic, donut shapes of red blood cells, they take on the characteristic ragged, fragile, sickle shapes. This makes it harder for them to pass through narrow blood vessels. It also makes them prone to hemolysis. This leads to occlusion and ischemia. Typical symptoms of sickle cell anemia include anemia, pain crisis, acute chest syndrome, organ damage, and silent stroke. Therapies for sickle cell anemia can be divided into 2 categories, symptom management and potential cure. For symptom management, daily pain relievers and antibiotics have traditionally been prescribed to reduce pain severity, infection, and incidence of sickle cell crisis. Hydroxyurea has also been approved to reduce the frequency of painful episodes by increasing fetal hemoglobin production, in addition to other potential mechanisms. Newer approved therapies inhibit sickling by preferential binding to non-polymerizing conformation of sickle hemoglobin. Furthermore, regular transcranial Doppler ultrasound is recommended to monitor blood vessel narrowing in the brain in order to prevent silent strokes. Blood transfusion is also used as needed to replace sickle red blood cells with healthy ones. Curative strategies for sickle cell anemia include bone marrow transplant to provide patients with hematopoietic stem cells containing healthy beta globin genes. In addition, gene therapies hold promise to address the genetic cause of sickle cell anemia by reverting thymine back to adenine in the beta chain of adult hemoglobin, or reactivating fetal hemoglobin production to replace the mutated beta globin in adults. However, these technologies still need further development to transform into safe, low-cost, consistently effective, and widely accessible therapies for many sickle cell anemia patients. Sickle cell anemia is considered a recessive genetic disorder, meaning a person needs to inherit both copies of mutated beta globin gene from their parents to develop sickle cell anemia. If only one copy of sickle beta globin is inherited, the individual will not develop sickle cell anemia. However, as they still carry a mutated beta globin gene, they can pass it on to their children. Third, genetic counseling and early diagnosis through universal newborn screening, in addition to standard long-term care, are crucial to improve survival for sickle cell anemia patients.